All right, how's everybody doing? Can y'all hear me? Yes, that's sauce. Well, that's all I got displayed at the moment. I guess I could start by both showing you what I was working on up until the stream started. A large piece I work on in my spare time, everyone. Someday I'll finish it. Time to sign in. How's the day treating you so far? Or evening for you, Sparks? Yep, that's a beret. A regimental beret. Showing a Scottish heritage. Cutlass. Thistle adornment. Of course, I can't pronounce the name dagger. Ian Dubbin. I don't speak Gaelic. Obviously. The idea is he's holding on to a 1-inch Gatling gun. That gun measures about 6 feet long. He's a big fella. Suppose we should get to why you really came. This is the model I'll be starting with, the Kodiak. Everybody see that? Got 3 heavy Macs and 2 heavy rocket 10s. Interesting configuration. 12 damage tracks. Huge. What I got to be looking out for is the Wizzo, so it's got a cockpit that can hold 2. Heavy Macs, 1 in each arm, 1 in the center. Rocket 10s, probably up on the shoulder. Flanking the cockpit. Right, and as this is all about sculpting, I thought I'd start out with sketching. Usually I do this with pencil and paper, but online this is probably better. At least slightly more interesting. So silhouettes are pretty important in design work. If your figure can be recognizable as a silhouette, it's probably a good, solid design. Depending on how you detail it, you can screw it up, but start with the silhouette and see if you can get something distinctive. It helps you work out in your head some of the shapes you're going to be trying to put together before you actually get in there and do it. And it just helps get your gears rolling in the right direction. So, got some specifics. Obviously going to have paragons and one in each arm and then the third one in the center. That would either be probably either dorsally mounted in his torso. Since he's going to have rocket launchers, which are probably going to be holders, I'll probably keep the weapon in. Might make him a little stocky. A little stuff. Try and translate that into another view. If you have any questions, drop them in chat, and hopefully I'll notice them and try and come up with a coherent explanation. Prophecy and quit. This is a Wacom's the Cintiq 24 Pro, I believe. I've been using Cintiq before they put monitors in. I've tried other ones, but even though drivers on Wacom are very frustrating sometimes, it's one of those software packages you just don't want to update when they first come out. You certainly don't want to update in the middle of doing a job or anything important, but their hardware, rock solid. Never found anything that performs quite like it or has the form factor of them. For a while I was using the companion too, but I was just plugging it into my main computer, so when it came time to replace it, I just got this one. Got some is in there. Fully formed, nothing formed because it's able to change. Here, I gotta Elmer Thrill. Forward. Did this done so I can it's the Kodiak. Can you see the data card for the Kodiak here in the part of the screen? I kind of like the shape, but I'm not fond of where the arms are located, being long down, so I think I'm going to raise them. Oh. Yeah, it's probably very tiny on your phone. We've got the three Heavy Max, two Heavy Rocket 10s. That's a pretty solid hitter there. 12 damage track, so he's monstrous. Probably on the bulk of the pillager. Bigger phone. Got a little light. Important part. Like a st- I got some basic shape. Turn our attention back to the actual program. I will load a starter in the kind of some of the scaled items like a hex base and a 10 millimeter figure. Starting file. There we go. That'd be a 10 millimeter figure in comparison to a 5 millimeter. 5 millimeter? Aircraft and hovercraft. Start with a primitive. If you use ZBrush, you know that when you save a tool out, it always uses the name of the topmost tool here as the file of the name. I find that annoying because I like to name my subtools. They're supposed to be the name of the file, so star primitive. Top of the stack. Off. I can give it the proper name. Centered. Lock out. Basic form. First question is, how big should the 12DT model? Pretty big. I think I'm going to start at about 's just a quick and dirty way to proportion him. Another way, if you're this is end of basically. Draw out kind of structure. Good day there, Colonel Kane. Keep these appendages getting straight and boring. Putting shapes on top of them. Pose them in. About your weapons. Keep moving around until you is a positioning guide. Marks, what software do you use when you model? At 3D Studio Max? Blender. I do use Blender for a number of things. Get into a little bit of that. Yeah, they switched back to a right-click scheme. Repetitive flow purposes. They got a really good excuse for doing it, but kind of throws a mess into things for some of us. I'm certainly liking the latest iteration better than previous ones. I've never actually used the sculpting blender. It appeared to be quite good. Yeah, on manifold geometry. Well, that was interesting. Thanks, Cav Boss. You might want to look into a plugin called RetopoFlow. I use it a lot, actually, especially when it comes to taking something that high poly mesh, remapping it so it's a low poly mesh. I'll just throw it into Blender and use RetopoFlow and go over and get the geometry I want, so I've got a nice small file to working with big blocky items in the beginning. Get your shapes right. Find to be invaluable. A little more. horrible. A good idea to start organizing things in folders now that does that. Item. Blender comes with a lot right out of the gate. Can't beat that price point. What do you think? Looking a little more like a cav? Oh, it's the door. Hold on a moment. That. Parks, are you still in school? Yeah. You're taking engineering, correct? Awesome. Show us how it's really done. Sure, this interface looks quite alien to you. A lot of people have a lot of problems getting over the interface. Time as well. But it's... it's like one of those things where you can't really envision other ways of doing it until you're doing it. Everything that I was being told about how the interface helps with your workflow in this kind of design environment, specifically made for hard surface modeling, it's complex, more organic stuff. But once I got over the interface, started to. I guess it's like doing a science experiment, where you don't necessarily understand the outcomes until it happens, and oh yeah. like buoyancy. Not really clicking that buoyancy about everything in space. Not just things that float in the ocean, but float in the air. It's all about displacement. Your house sits on the foundation, which is floating. Start to make those little connections as you study. ZBrush interface is kind of like that. Oh, so you you do use ZBrush. Awesome. I wasn't aware you were actually. Aliens. Not hearing anything from Todd or Ross, I figured if anybody, you guys would have lots of opinions about design work. Opportunity to guide things before get too far into the design process. Yeah, it's hard to beat that price point. That have got arm shapes in there. No, those are going to be separate pieces for the final product. ever good to make the weapons that are the same look. There is an incredible urge to start detailing things as you go. As I work on this, I'm already in my head. I've got foot all over this. I want to go in and do it, but you got to fight that urge to fill out the machine, work on everything all at once, call it a whole. That way, when it comes down to finishing off the model, it doesn't look like you built this part and added this part to it. It looks like it was all built and designed by companies. Look as haphazard as it all fit together. It'll click, flow. Boxes up. Rocket tank. questions? That be hashtag swag? What? Well, it doesn't necessarily have to be about the sculpting itself. About concepting. Weapons. I might not be able to answer. Hey, Gimli. Hey. This is the Kodiak. King of Bears. Yeah, they are quite hefty. Hopefully a little bit later I'll get into some real magic there, Krugeran. Depends on the model. If John has an idea in his head, he will certainly not be shy about giving it to me. The workflow we're trying to maintain is that the data cards are made first, then the cabs are designed afterward. But sometimes we'll just see cool shapes, and we just keep a folder of just lots of cool little signs and can sort of get inspiration from if we need it. But sometimes I'm just left completely on my own. Sometimes I create things without even telling him. Like to offset the knee joint. These things actually look like they can bend their legs back in a angle. Bit of a more interesting profile. What about you, Todd? You got any opinions on the design so far? Questions? That certainly works too. bit of magic for you. Brush does things weird, but it does. Sort of like as an auxiliary weapon where you can just bring it forward. I'm down with that. Definitely don't. But about an hour, and we've already got machine, recognizable machine, highly detailed one. Cool. Assembled on site. Really big. Sure, what you're referring to there. or so does. officially have Todd's approval. Got all these different shapes. Art. I lowered the rocket launchers. I kind of want to lower that part and the arms too. At least pull them out a little bit so cutting in. So. There's the model. Put on item assembly. The transpose, reach piece and move. Pastel. I've got something that I'm just... No objection. A cockpit. The idea was I wanted to carve out this top ridge at the cockpit. Who is I'm oh, poly. Increases. All shape body a little add a lot more do as I'm gonna do. This is a sculptress bind. Allows you to add geometry as you sculpt. Mechanic sculpt. Alright, Sparks. Later. Good rest. Start cutting in the body. Area that cock. That's a tablet. Can't read. There we go. Out. Apology. Ugly. But it's me the What do you know? great for panic. Have to read or so down with that cockpit. Different program. Export. That is an okay. Top of so you see this red line that down there, that just means I have symmetry on. I have to do half the model. vets have to provide that in there just all the way. Oops. Poly pen. Nose curve and then map that to the surface model. No, people. A lot of people dread retopolizing their models. Point. For me, it just makes manipulating things. Done. Gaps in there because it get those close enough. Go over to ZBrush. See the original I've got. Duplicate. Worth this. Currently have some. Exported that wrong. Got to currently selected, not the thing. See how much nerd. That out, that's much easier to deal with. Of course, if you're new here, I encourage you to join, get notifications. Hopefully you find this interesting, if not entertaining. Probably be saving this, not working on it during the week and just get to continue this stream. Can see the whole process. Here's just basic shapes. Start detailing it and adding more complex forms to it. Final detail posing. Making sure it's scaled right and then finally cutting it up. Production parts and exporting it. Boss to do something with, hopefully. Guns look plain, don't they? Point for the reference pilot longer needs. Pilots. Probably not going to need them much, but I'm going to light post that. And posing the fits on his base. Base fits inside styrene black base that. Some since this will probably be laying in the mold around mine like that, I don't want to get wild and go too deep into that barrel. Tear the mold. Add a top and a bottom detail. Congratulations there, Todd. Chores are done. Yeah, I know. Just can't hold a conversation and work at the same time. When I was younger, I used to stick my tongue out a lot when I was concentrating. At least I don't do that anymore. Compressor on the end. Want me to talk more? You're half of that muzzle. Heat of the barrel. Have these sharp sticking out. Offsetting, I'm like, aesthetic. Painters like fiddly bits that stick out, right? Righty. Hear that? Beginnings. Monster. Breaks into the middle gun as well, but at the end of my time, oh, out, up, next. Thank you all for joining me. Again, if you haven't already, follow and get some notifications and enjoy the rest of your CAV-CON. Turning it back over to you, CAV-Boss.